The Passwords app in iOS 18 makes managing your passwords easier than ever. It's not just about storing passwords anymore. You can store Wi-Fi passwords, two-factor authentication codes, and even special passkeys. Plus, if any of your passwords are weak or show up in a data breach, it will let you know, helping you stay safe. And make sure to stick around until the end, and I'll show you how to download a PDF of all these tips for free. So let's dive in. To begin, the Passwords app is now a separate app in iOS 18. Previously, it was part of the iCloud keychain. When you tap on it, you'll see a lock screen. You can use Face ID, Touch ID, or your passcode to unlock it, just like you would when unlocking your iPhone. When you first open the Passwords app, you'll see a Welcome to the Passwords app screen. It will ask you if you want to turn on autofill, which makes it easier to fill in passwords automatically when you log in to websites or apps. Go ahead and tap Turn On. You'll also see an option asking if you want to receive notifications, which will alert you to any potential security issues. If you want to receive these, tap Continue and then tap Allow Notifications. At the top of the app, you'll see a search bar. You can quickly search for any password you need by typing in the name of the app or website. If you prefer, you can also use the All section to browse your saved passwords alphabetically. You can sort them by the date they were edited or created as well, giving you flexibility in how you organize your information. There are a few different ways to add a new password. You can manually add a password by tapping the plus sign in the lower right corner. A form will appear where you can type the website name, app name, or label you choose, then add your username. When you tap on the password field, the app will suggest a secure password for you. You can use this suggestion or type in your own if you prefer. If you're happy with the generated password, tap Save. But you can also automatically create a password and add it to the app when you create an account on a website. For instance, if I want to create a new Amazon account in Safari, I open Safari, go to Amazon.com, tap Sign In Securely, then tap on Create Account. I'll enter a first name and last name, a mobile number or email, and then when I tap on Create a Password, it pops up and prompts me to create a strong password using the Passwords app. I tap Save and Fill, and the password is saved to the Passwords app, and I can continue through any additional verification checks to finish creating the account. However, if I want to create the password in an application, the process will be slightly different depending on the application I'm using. Using our Amazon example, if I open the Amazon app, tap Sign In Securely, I'm going to select Create Account, and then on this screen, we enter the first and last name, mobile number or email, and then when I tap on Create Password, the keyboard pops up. But above the keyboard is the word Passwords. I tap that, and that will take me directly into the Passwords application. I can then create a new password, enter the username, the strong password is automatically generated, and then when I tap Done, the password is populated. Both these methods provide you with flexibility to create and store passwords in the Passwords app on your iPhone. Next, let's discuss passkeys. Passkeys are becoming more common as a more secure and simple way to log into apps and websites without using traditional passwords. They work with your Face ID or fingerprint, making the process secure and seamless. As an example, I'm going to create a passkey for my Amazon account. I open the app, I tap my profile icon in the lower toolbar, tap on Your Account, tap on Login and Security, and if you're prompted to enable autofill, make sure you do that at this point. Then I tap Setup next to Passkey. Tap Setup again. I'm going to enable Face ID to handle the passkey going forward. Now, anytime that I log in, it'll use the passkey to authenticate me instead of the password. So tap in Sign In Securely. You'll notice here it's prompting to use the passkey. Tap Continue. And that's all there is to it. Passkeys provide an extra layer of security without the hassle of remembering complicated passwords, and they are supported by many popular websites and apps like Amazon and Google. The Password app can also act as an authenticator, helping you manage two-factor authentication codes for all your accounts. Many companies offer authenticator apps, including Google and Microsoft. They're often interchangeable, so you can use one authenticator to log into all your different apps and sites. For example, I'm going to set up two-factor authentication for my Amazon account here. Once I log into Amazon, I want to go into my account settings and then choose security. From here, I will choose login and security. Then I can select two-factor authentication. Then I choose the authenticator app option, and on the next screen, I'll scan the QR code with my iPhone camera. My iPhone will open the passwords app and ask me which Amazon account to associate with two-factor authentication. Now, as you can see, when I open the Amazon app, I enter my email address, and on the next screen, it asks me for my OTP code. I go into the passwords app, tap codes, then use the 6-digit code to finish logging in. This makes it easier to secure your accounts without needing a third-party authenticator app. If you ever need to share a password with someone you trust, like a family member, the Passwords app makes this easy. To start, tap on New Group under the Shared Group option. The next screen gives you some details about shared groups. Tap Continue. Give your group a name, like Family in this instance. Then you can choose who to share with using a name, email, or phone number. There's one important restriction to sharing with the Passwords app. Everyone needs to be using an Apple device running at least iOS 17. If someone in your group doesn't have their device updated to at least iOS 17, you'll get a message letting you know that you can't share with them. Once you've selected the people you want to share with, tap Add, then Create. Now you can choose which passwords you want to share with your saved list. Tap on the ones you want, and then tap Move to add them to the shared group. You'll then be asked if you want to notify the group members through messages about the new shared list. Since this is a test, I'm not going to notify them. If you update any password within the shared group, the people in the group will also have the updated version, keeping everyone in sync. The Passwords app also keeps an eye out for any security issues. If you tap Security, you'll see a list of any passwords that may have been compromised. This could mean it's a weak password or that it was exposed in a data breach. You can tap any of the compromised passwords and you'll be taken to the site where you need to change it. If you want to delete a password, go to the All tab, swipe left on the password you want to remove, and tap Delete. The app keeps it for 30 days in the deleted section in case you change your mind and you can recover it. Just tap on deleted and swipe on the password to tap recover and it will go back into your saved passwords. Managing Wi-Fi passwords is easily one of the best features in the new Passwords app. You'll find a list of all the Wi-Fi networks you're connected to. If you ever need to share your Wi-Fi with guests, you can tap on the network and then tap Show Network QR Code. Your guests can scan this code and instantly connect without needing you to manually share the password. And that's it. If you want a PDF of all these great tips, you can download it in the video description below. And as you can see, Apple has designed this app to be simple yet powerful, making it the go-to option for most people managing passwords on their devices. It's a great way to stay organized and keep your information secure. Thanks for watching. I hope this guide helped you feel more confident using the Passwords app, and don't forget to subscribe for more tips. I'll see you in the next video.